Welcome to Mushkil Ashan. I am Charlotte DeCoster, clinical psychologist, National Institute of Behavioral Sciences. Children are reflections of God. They are sweet, caring, loving individuals till they irritate you. Yes, our topic for today is hyperactivity of children during this period of lockdown. Now, children usually they spend some time in school, few at home, and sometimes also they spend a part of their daily activity playing games outside. During this lockdown period, if we see, children have been confined to their 2 BHK or 1 BHK or this one room, and definitely they are unable to run, speak, play the way they used to earlier. They are unable to meet their friends, and this is hampering their mental as well as physical states. How is it hampering? Let us focus on it. Children, if we see, since they are not attending school the way they would be, and as well as unable to go to play the way they used to, they're engaging more time in mobile phones or they're running around the home. Now, fidgety activity of children, as well as their inattention or asking too many questions, is sometimes a sign of curiosity, creativity. However, can this be a disorder? In certain cases, yes. Now, hyperactivity, whether it's a disorder or not, depends upon whether the child is manifesting these symptoms. What are these symptoms? Number one, the child is restless. Many children are fidgety, but restless here means they have difficulty sitting in one place for a prolonged period of time. They are usually climbing or running about, or else they are sometimes hitting or unable to speak to you while standing in one place. They are always moving about, hurting others. And that is consistent over time as well as over place. They are also inattentive. Inattentive as in they are unable to complete the task that they have started, and sometimes they switch over to another task. Now, it is very common for children to sometimes bulldoze parents with questions. Why this is happening? Why this is not happening? What else should be happening? Why these things are this way? So it is common for them to ask questions. However, the inattention is at a diagnostic level if and only if their inattention starts hampering their academic results. It starts, it causes a great disturbance for their ability to even carry on the activities that they enjoy. A child unable to carry on studying is still pardonable, because the child is getting irritated or wants to concentrate on something else. You can say, okay, the child may be experiencing boredom. That cannot be to a diagnostic level. However, if the same child is unable to carry on drawing, coloring, or even watching television for a consistent period of time because the child is too fidgety or wants to engage in more activities, that can be at a diagnostic level. Now, children who are excessively hyperactive or excessively inattentive, they fall into the spectrum of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Now, it can be like those one of vanilla ice creams, where only hyperactivity is there, or just strawberry ice cream, where inattention is there. Or it can also be a two-in-one, where it's a combined approach, where hyperactivity is also there and inattention is also there. However, this condition can definitely be improved. Now, parents have to understand how they are going to react to it: frustrated, irritated, or understanding. Now the child is not doing this something out of choice. ADHD is not a choice. It is a product. Now, as simply and easily parents can understand that, treatment can be that much simple and easy. We are always there for you. If you have any queries regarding this, or if you want to know anything in detail regarding this disorder, do write to us in this comment section. If you've liked this video, do share and subscribe. We are going to see you next week. Take care. Goodbye.